What I have here is a document in regards to our cyber school technology solution for any information in regards to our software, that is digital science and virtual lab. The simplest way of having or helping a student learn science subjects. We have hundreds of teachers across the country acquiring the software, which is digital science and virtual lab. Of course, many thanks to the schools that have already managed to acquire the software itself. Green Hill Academy in there, Seroma Christian High School in Mukono. We also have Aga Khan High School, including Burenga Light Vocational School, and of course, New Horizon Secondary School in Mukono. It doesn't matter which part of the country, for as long as you're interested in the software, accessible via our main offices, that is in Lugogo Uma Showgrounds, that is in Cyber School Technology Solutions. Many thanks for the feedback on our Facebook and Twitter handle, that is CSTSUG, or our email address, that is info@cyberschooltech.co.ug. Coming up is chemistry. My guess is you don't like the subject. Why? Because you never got the chance to carry out the experiment. Every time you open a chemistry textbook, it was always numbers and letters. Coming up is a chemistry teacher explaining this using digital science and virtual lab, molecules in 3D and chemicals in color.
Welcome, digital science, known as Cyber School, to Green Hill Academy Secondary School. And today, I'm going to introduce you to digital science in classroom environment. We are going to have senior three class, and it's going to be an evening or afternoon lesson that we are going to have tonight. And our topic today is going to be the preparation of sulfur dioxide gas. Today we want to look at the sulfur dioxide. First of all, you need to know that sulfur dioxide is a gas that we can prepare in the lab. Alright? And that's why I'm saying we shall prepare lab preparation of dry sulfur dioxide gas. Now we have our teacher here, our IT teacher. Very good. We are saying sulfur dioxide can be prepared in two ways. Very good. The first one. We are saying that number one, we can using sodium sulfite. In bracket there is a word in the bracket, and I even underlined it. Can we pronounce that word as a class?
Sorry.
Very good. Then we have dilute hydrochloric acid. There is a word in the bracket there. Can we pronounce it?
Liquid.
Very good. Now, there is a reason why I said this one is a solid, the other one is what?
Liquid.
Which I need you to remember that and have it at your fingertips. So let us look at the second way. Using copper metal, there is a word in the bracket.
Solid.
Good. Then and, let us all read that together. In bracket?
Liquid.
Very good. Now you need to take note of these things. One is a solid, another one is a liquid. Even the second one. One is a solid, another one is a liquid. There is a reason why I emphasized and I underlined, as we are going to see in the next slide. So can we switch to Cyber and we see? Okay. I reduced the volume, I've reduced it because I want you to hear me. Okay. What is the name of this instrument? Girl. It is? Dropping funnel. Very good. Uh-huh. Then there is something here. Sodium sulfite. What is the color? Someone seeing the color? With your naked eyes. Yes, the color. It is white. Very good. I hope it's not like the white people. Now, sodium sulfite is white. And the state is? Solid. Dilute sulfuric acid is a liquid, and we put it up here. There is a reason why we put it up and we put this one what? Down. Uh-huh. Why did we put sodium sulfite in the round bottomed flask? Yes. So solid, very good. And why did we put dilute sulfuric acid in the dropping funnel, Avanti? It's a liquid. Very good. Now, what could happen if we exchange and we say, we need our sodium sulfate up there. We put it up. What can happen? Ampere? Someone is saying it will block the delivery tube and will not move down. I want now, someone should modify it, that movement there. Look at the properties of solids and properties of gases, of liquids. That moving, how do we say, how do we correlate it with the properties of solids and liquids? Someone is putting up the hand? Yes, please. Very good. Sodium sulfate will not flow. But if we put a liquid easily does what? Flows. Properties of solids and liquid. That's why we put liquid up and a solid down. Very good. Now, can you let that gas now move? Can we stop there? Very good. Have you seen how the gas is moving? And it is now here. Now, there is a bottle here, and we have labeled conch sulfuric acid. But remember, I said that when we are labeling up the diagram, the setup, we don't abbreviate. We write full, complete words. So this one shall be concentrated sulfuric acid. What's the use of concentrated sulfuric acid in that case now? We've been preparing gases, hydrogen, and those things. Karan? Someone is saying it dries the gas. Good. Concentrated sulfuric acid dries the gas. Why didn't we use any other reagent to dry that gas? Because there are many other drying agents. There are many other drying agents. Why didn't we use Kezia? Someone is saying that sulfur dioxide is acidic. Remember, is it acidic?
Yes.
Someone is saying no. Can I hear a strong no? Is sulfur dioxide acidic?
Yes.
Why is it acidic? Why do we call it acidic? Yes. That gas, if you put there any litmus paper, it will turn to red. Okay, that's good. But do you remember when you looked at classes of oxides? How many classes of oxide did we have? Okay, remind one, four, huh? Number one?
Acidic oxides,
yes. Basic oxides, good. Amphoteric oxides? Neutral oxides. So now I'm interested in acidic oxides. Can you give me examples of acidic oxides? Examples, yes, please. Sulfur dioxide, and now that settles it. So sulfur dioxide is an acidic oxide. Therefore, acids can be dried by an acid. Reason? Someone told us it does not react with the acid. Very good. Can we now continue now? We see how this gas is going to move. Can our gas move? Are you seeing the gas moving? Can you stop there? It moved like this. It went through the delivery tube and then it went downwards. What method could that be? Which method of collection is that? Hand up, chepchot. Pardon? Downward delivery. Because the gas is being delivered downwards. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Very good. Why are we collecting it by downward delivery? Not any other method. Sulfur dioxide is denser than
air.
That's very good. That's very good. Now, that is if we are just drawing math. Someone may tell you to explain how sulfur dioxide can be prepared in the lab. Now, someone should be able to put in all the reasons we have given why you are putting sodium sulfate up and sodium sulfate down and the sulfuric acid up. You should be able to tell us why it is dried with sulfuric acid. You should be able to tell us why you are collecting it by downward delivery.
You're welcome to Green Hill Academy. Chibuli and Buwate. My name is Veronica Joy Maraka. I'm the rector of the school, but basically I'm a teacher, and I am a science teacher. I'm a teacher for chemistry and biology, and I have been teaching for very many years, about 40 to be precise. And I'm very passionate about teaching, and I'm very passionate about science. Because I've been teaching for a very long time, I have seen very many changes. The first one, for instance, is there were very few lady science teachers. Now there are very many lady science teachers, and we're very happy about that. The second one is that we didn't have very many practicals being done, and the practicals were physical. Where we are now in Uganda and in Green Hill, we have practicals being done physically in the lab, but we have also a lot of simulations in the lab, and we don't have to do very many things. I remember when we were doing titers in chemistry, you would actually suck in the sodium hydroxide. When you were doing physics, you had to do so many things manually. But now we have moved on, and we don't have to do all those things. It makes science teaching a lot more interesting. You get a lot of buy-in from the students and also from the teachers. It also helps you to have a bigger scope, because when you are doing something practically or manually in the lab, you can only deal with a certain area. But if you're doing or you're dealing with it using digital science, you can look at all other institutions and you can compare with very many other places and situations.